A decade plus ago, SpaceX stood no chance against Boeing, the venerable behemoth at the forefront of the aerospace industry. Now fast forward to 2020, Boeing is struggling immensely with the Starliner aircraft. But against all odds, SpaceX became the first privately held company to be awarded a contract to send humans to orbit, putting the once untouchable Boeing to shame. Now, how did SpaceX and Elon Musk manage to outwit their adversaries despite all odds stacked against them? Well, you'll find out in just a second, but before that, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. As mentioned previously, Boeing is still a venerable giant with a legacy in aeroplanes and aerospace that stretched back more than 100 years and a role in every major moment in NASA's history. SpaceX, on the other hand, was derided as little more than a delusional billionaire's fantasy, and that critics said was building its rockets out of wax and rubber bands during its early days. No one thought Elon Musk's SpaceX would ever beat Boeing to space. Some members of Congress even wondered why NASA would bother awarding contracts to two companies to build capsules to fly astronauts to the International Space Station under NASA's Commercial Crew Program. They just wanted to let Boeing do the job. Years of hard work and toil later, SpaceX won the NASA contract to send astronauts to the International Space Station last year in 2020, beating Boeing. The launch of SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule with astronauts aboard will not only be the first crewed launch to orbit by a private corporation, but also a major upset in a new kind of space race. During the Apollo era, NASA was driven to the moon by a Cold War space race with the Soviet Union, but today companies are reprising the roles of nations in competitions that NASA hopes will help it recapture some of the achievements of a bygone era. Or take it a few steps further. Publicly, the companies downplay any tension. But the competition has grown bitter over the years, particularly as SpaceX went from a rich man's folly no one took seriously to a disruptor that transformed the aerospace industry. When the contracts for the Commercial Crew Program were awarded in 2014, Boeing received the lion's share, slightly more than 60% of the $6.8 billion NASA awarded, getting $4.2 billion compared to the $2.6 billion SpaceX received for the same amount of work. Boeing still ruled the minds and influenced the decision of the decision-makers. It was informed by an unwillingness to hand it over to a company that was brash and willing to accept failure compared to a company that already had decades of experience and only put things into motion after receiving a 100% assurance of non-failure. The company has lots of NASA contracts under its belt, including contributions to the Apollo program. It is therefore puzzling to contemplate how. Boeing is struggling with a Starliner aircraft NASA contracted it to build while SpaceX continues to record success after success. Boeing has been moving from one embarrassment to another as it cancels flight after flight. We look at the spectacular failure the Starliner is becoming for Boeing. The Starliner journey began for Boeing when it got one of a pair of contracts from NASA in 2010. The Boeing CST-100 Starliner is a class of two reusable crew capsules expected to transport crew to the International Space Station, ISS. As of September 2021, Starliner has not flown a crewed mission, facing delays after delays. The capsule has a diameter of 4.56 meters or 15 feet, which is slightly larger than the Apollo Command Module and SpaceX Dragon 2, and smaller than the Orion capsule. The Boeing Starliner holds a crew of up to 7 people and is designed to be able to remain docked to ISS for up to 7 months, with the reusability of up to 10 missions. It is designed to be compatible with the Atlas V, Delta IV, Falcon 9, and Vulcan Centaur launch vehicles. This means NASA wants this to be usable with very wide flexibility and to reduce their overall reliance on Boeing. After several rounds of competitive development contracts within the Commercial Crew Program starting in 2010, NASA selected the Boeing Starliner along with SpaceX Crew Dragon for the Commercial Crew Transportation Capability CCT-CAP program, with an award of $4.2 billion in 2014, and this, as you very well know, Boeing lost. In the late 2019, the uncrewed Boeing Starliner orbital flight test, BO-OFT, launched with the Atlas V N22 and reached orbit, but was not completely successful. Boeing self-funded a second test flight, BO-OFT-2, which was to launch in August 2021, but was scrubbed before launch due to valve issues in the propulsion system. The mission was rescheduled for early 2022. This Starliner program is steeped in Boeing's past history with NASA and the great heights they want to continue to reach. Its design draws upon Boeing's experience with NASA's Apollo, Space Shuttle, and ISS programs, as well as the Orbital Express project, sponsored by the Department of Defense. Starliner will use the NASA docking system for docking and use the Boeing lightweight ablator for its heat shield. The Starliner's solar cells will provide more than 2.9 kilowatts of electricity and will be placed on top of the micrometeoroid debris shield located at the bottom of the spacecraft service module. it is designed to be compatible with multiple launch vehicles, including the Atlas V, Delta IV, and Falcon 9, as well as the planned Vulcan Centaur. Unlike earlier United States space capsules and SpaceX's very own Starship, Starliner will make airbag cushion landings on the ground rather than into water. 5 landing areas are planned in the western United States, which will give the Starliner about 450 landing opportunities every year. Starliner includes 1 space tourist seat, and the Boeing contract with NASA allows Boeing to price and sell passage to low Earth orbit on that seat. Boeing got an additional $300 million to cover its expenses for overshooting its own project timeline, and they decided to launch its spacecraft atop a United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket, while SpaceX planned to blast off Crew Dragon with its heavy-duty Falcon 9 booster rocket. From that moment onward, Boeing could not avoid the progress of its Starliner being compared with what SpaceX is achieving with its Crew Dragon and now Starship. The comparison is pitiful, even though both contractors ended up falling behind their original schedules due to a myriad of reasons. Boeing's woes began even before getting to orbit. While testing the Starliner's launch orbit engines in June of 2019, a propellant leak caused the capsule's development to be pushed back. Starliner did make it to orbit in December of 2019, almost a decade after getting the contract. However, it turned out to be a huge failure, as the Starliner did not reach the ISS due to a timing glitch to cause it to burn fuel prematurely. Instead, the capsule returned to Earth in a shortened test flight. In the post-flight analysis by Boeing and NASA, the team discovered over 80 corrective actions that Boeing had to take. The corrective actions covered integrated testing and simulation processes and operation software. It took Boeing more than a year to fix all the corrections, including the ones it discovered on its own, and get the Starliner ready for another flight test, although it would use a new spacecraft. The second attempt at a Starliner, the flight was scheduled to take place before April the 1st. However, the planned flight had to be postponed due to the widespread power outage that Texas suffered earlier this year. A string of hard luck and technical problems awaited the Starliner. The uncrewed flight scheduled for July the 30th to verify the spacecraft systems had to be postponed because a week earlier, the space station was sent into a spin when a newly added Russian module, the Nacker, inadvertently fired its thrusters. The Starliner was already stacked on its rocket on the next launch date, but a severe thunderstorm ominously rolled through the launch area the day before problems started during the countdown when 13 of the valves in the Starliner's propulsion system failed to open, causing the launch to be called off due to its troubleshooting. Boeing engineers got 9 of the valves to work, but the remaining 4 remained stuck. The program director for the Starliner, John Vollmer, commented that they had been able to free all of the valves. The Starliner would have been fit to fly, but in the end, it had to return to the factory. Clearly, the Starliner is plagued with an endless list of problems and issues to trudge through before it can have a chance at a successful flight. We have yet to see whether the flight planned in 2022 will even go through or not. Aside from that, it's a question of Boeing's legitimacy in the aerospace industry and whether it can continue in the same capacity or not. Regardless, we can confidently say that SpaceX has decisively taken the mantle. So, what do you think? Do you think Boeing can still make a comeback? Or is SpaceX's victory truly complete? Let us know what you think in the comments below. And if you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video that is shown in the end screen. I'll see you there.